Good morning, dear children. How are you all? Yes, you all are excellent and fine and safe at home. Today we will see a new lesson from Beehive, the book of Beehive. Okay, lesson number 9. That is, I think, so second last lesson from this book. That is The Bond of Love, written by Kenneth Anderson. Written by Kenny Anderson. Here, the very good story, very interesting story, the love between human being and animal. So, what is that I will explain. Okay, so the Bond of Love is written by Kenneth Anderson. Kenneth Anderson is born on 8th March 1910 and died on 30th August 1974. Was an Indian-born British writer and hunter who wrote books about his adventures in jungle of South India. He was from a Scottish family that settled in India for 6 generations. His father, Douglas Swetart Anderson, was superintendent of FCMA in Pune, Maharashtra. He dealt with the salaries paid to military personnel, having an honorary rank of captain. His father had a rifle, hunted for waterfowl, and influenced Anderson's decision to become a hunter. As his father was working in a forest area, you know, so he was attracted towards that hunting. So he has written, you know, many books about the adventurers in jungles, especially of South India. This is very small information about Kenneth Anderson. Okay, now we will see a summary. Summary, what is the theme of this lesson? So here I have written, The Bond of Love is a story of emotional bonding between a woman and a bear. Okay, bear, teddy bear that we say that the bear, okay, cool. Bear. The author once found an orphan sloth bear and presented it to his wife. The animal and his wife couldn't live apart from each other. The narrator is highlighting, that is the main, the bond of love. Here we can understand the title, The Bond of Love. The bond of love in between the narrator's wife and that animal. Which is that animal? That is a sloth bear. That is bear. Okay. Apart from each other, the narrator is highlighting the fact that a wrong act can be redeemed by man if he or she makes an attempt to do so. Animals, wild or domestic, respond equally love and affection. Actually, the bear is not a pet animal, or we cannot say the domestic animal. But still, here the narrator is telling all of us that the narrator is highlighting the fact that a wrong act can be redeemed by man if he, she makes an attempt to do so. Animals, wild or domestic, respond equally love and affection. What is that story, that small summary we will see, and then we will go in the next lecture, we will see a detailed explanation. The summary, the story, The Bond of Love is about a very wonderful relationship between a bear and narrator's wife, just now I said. So it so happened that while on a hunt, when I just now explained that about narrator's family, where his father was also working. Okay, so it so happened that while on hand, the mothers of a sloth bear was shot dead. Was shot dead, mother of the sloth bear was shot dead by the narrator and his friends. All of a sudden, they noticed a little baby bear sitting anxiously near its mother. You know, we see always that even feelings are there, human feelings are always there. Okay, so that even though like a human being, they also sit beside them, they also sit beside them near its mother. The narrator ran up and captured it. It put it in a gunny bag. He has taken that baby bear, the calf of bear, and put it in a gunny bag and gifted it to his wife. A very strong bond of love developed between the two, these two. However, after a while, the grown bear was taught tough to handle. When he grown up, it was very tough to handle it and was sent to zoo. Both the mistress and her bear lived in a very stressful situation. You know, we'll see, I will tell you in detail also. So when they were apart, that they both were, means wife of narrator and bear, that animal, when they aparted each other, they were in stressful situation. With the permission of the superintendent, they were able to realize him from retrieve him from the zoo. Once it was back, they created an island for him to live a free and wonderful life. His human mom would go and spend time with him every day. This is a short summary. So this summary also we'll see in detail. Okay, so first of all, we are going to be seeing what we are going to be seeing. The narrator finds an orphan bear. The narrator, once this narrator and his, because of his father, narrator, who is a narrator? Of course, the Philip Anderson, the writer himself is a narrator. As his father was working in a forest area, so he got attracted towards hunting. So his friend circle and he himself went to hunting. That time they saw orphan bear. The narrator found a bear. When they were hunting, they shot gunshot to babies, that bear's mother, and there she died on the spot. And it was died, so the bear, this calf of bear, was sitting very, you know, nervously sitting beside its mother. Okay, bear cup by chance when he had his friends were passing through the fields of sugarcane. They went to sugarcane, okay, means in the field of sugarcane. And sugarcane near Mysore, as they were from South India. And people were driving away the wild pigs from their fields by shooting at them. Sugarcane, most of the time, you know, in the fields, these wild animals come and they spoil their fields. So usually those people, they keep gun with them and the shotgun, they get give fear or they scared them, and because of that gun's noise they can go away. Okay, so in this way the shooting at them. Then they spotted a sloth bear. His friend shot towards the bear and it died. Bear had entered in the sugarcane field and his friend circle when shooted, that bear shooted there, shooting at the bear, towards the bear, and it died. After the sloth bear died, her cub, which was riding on her back, that small bear was riding on his back, and the mother died there and ran around her dead body making a sad noise. The narrator caught the beer cup and gifted it to his wife. The narrator's wife was so happy when she got this. She's fond of animals. When the narrator gave, she was so happy on seeing the beer cup and named him it Bruno. That when it has come at home, so named it Bruno. She treated him as her own child and took good care of him. Okay, she gave him many things eat to drink, the porridge and what? The vegetables, fruits, nuts, meat, many things. Like his own son, she always gave eatable, many different types of eatable items to eat, rice, eggs, etc. He spent his time in playing with the pet. They had the other pet also, and he always, that small bear, always spent time playing with the, they have the tenant children and the other pet animals like this. And when it was very small also, because it was a calf, young one of a bear, and he, like this, they spent his time in playing with her pet dogs for of the narrator and his tenants' children. He slept there in their beds only. He always slept in their bed only. So, what incident with the Bruno once? And see, animals are animals. That's why we always say, the human beings are the unique creature from God's hand, you know, by God. What is the difference between these animals and the human beings? We have brain to think. The animals doesn't have. They don't have. Okay, the animals don't have. The same thing is with the bear. So what incident, as it was growing, what incident took place once? What happened? Once the incident took place in the house. The narrator had put down a rat poison. Many rats were there, I think so. So he had kept that rat poison to kill rats in the library, and Bruno ate it and suffered a lot. Okay, so he suffered a lot, a stroke of paralysis. He drank, as soon as they come to know, he drank that poison. They took it to hospital, and that was terribly serious. And himself to the narrator's wife, they took him to the veterinary doctor, and he recovered after some time. And another time what happened? As the animals, they always play, Bruno drank 1 gallon of old engine oil, but it had no ill effect. Once, second time, he had the complete gallon, you know, the barrel, the full gallon. Gallon is a one type of a tank, you know, a bottle, we can say, that complete he drank. But nothing ill happened with him. See, and it has come there, they have kept his name Bruno. Okay, that Bruno, and after when it was growing up, he has the wife and the narrator, they have changed it names as a Baba. No more Bruno, so Baba. As Bruno grew, he learned some tricks, and at narrator's wife command, he could perform them. He could hold a stick like a gun. When she said wrestle or box, he did the same. She changed his name to Baba. When he grew up, Baba had to be chained most of the time children of narrator's tenant. When it was small, no problem. But when, as it was growing up, so they used to put him in the chain. Because of naughtiness and because of his all these activities, they used to put him in the chain. Okay. As the time passed, Baba grieved, sighs equally. Of course, wild animals, they always grieve, you know, in a very huge size and equal to the two dogs in height. Equal to the two dogs, and they have their Alsatian dogs as a pet in their house as well. So the narrator and his friends advised the narrator's wife to send him to zoo, as he had done the two things, that he had drunk the engine oil and the second the poison that they had kept for to kill rat. So, and as it grew in size, it was disturbing the tenant children also and the pet dogs also. So the others said that as it grew, it is not good safe to keep him, so send him in the zoo. So to the zoo in the Mysore, because he needed a bigger and open space. You can imagine the bear's size, the grown up bear's size. She was not ready to send him because they attracted towards each other. The bond of love was very fixed, you know, it was very close. So she was not ready, but as others were saying and it disturbing, so she was ready to send him to the zoo. Then, when they sent to the zoo, then the narrator's wife and the narrator, the animal, they both were in stress. They both were in tension, because if somebody goes away, the near one and dear one goes away from us, we can see the effect. So the same thing happened with bear also and the narrator's wife also. The narrator's wife was in a grief for weeks after Baba left. She wrote a letter to the custodian. The custodian where the Bruno had kept, the Baba had kept, of the zoo to know about Baba. The custodian, that is we can say the curator. Okay, replied that he was feeding, fretting and not eating food. See, the natural things. Even the animals, okay, she was a human being, she can understand. What about the animal? So animal, when it sent to in the zoo, it was also that Bruno was also, the Baba was also not eating food because of tension, because its loved one, that wife is not near with him. He is not, that animal is not in that house. The critter replied that he was fretting and not eating food. The narrator tried to keep her away from the zoo for about 3 months, but after knowing Baba's condition, she decided to meet, because she used to talk, and she realized that its condition is not good, let me go and see. Then his wife talked with his husband and asked, are you coming with me? I'm going to meet Baba. So if you are not coming, so let me go by train or by bus here nearby. It is a Mysore only. When they went, the others say, now few months left, now that Baba will not recognize you. But you know, dear children, when as she entered and she was before her cage from long distance, Baba recognized her as a mother, like narrator's wife. And from there only he shouted and jumping in very happy mood. She did not go to him, but still from far away he recognized his wife and he was jumping like anything. Narrator took his wife to the zoo. Some of her friends told her that Baba would not recognize her, but when she went to zoo, Baba recognized her at once and became very happy. They sat together for 3 hours. She gave him food. She urged the curator to send Baba with her, but it was helpless. He said that no, it is now the zoo's property, so you can't take. But if you will talk with the superintendent, the main boss of this zoo, if they will allow, definitely we will send. So she went to the superintendent, taken the permission from him, and they were ready. Actually, it is not, they are not supposed to, we cannot take like this way. But they could see the bond of love between both of them, and they gave the permission, and she could bring that Baba at home. Baba returns home very happily. The superintendent allowed her to take Baba and was hosted on the top of the narrator's car at home. A 20 feet long and a 15 feet wide island was made for him. Island. Big means on that island he cannot come out easily because it was disturbing others. But they made like that island and kept him there in their house. A wooden box was kept for Baba to sleep. He was happy to be at home again. The narrator's wife and Baba spent hours sitting there. What is that, the narrator's, why he gave that lesson? A bond of love between a human being and an animal. The affection and the love between the narrator's wife and Baba, the sloth bear. Okay, that name is a sloth bear, was a symbol of true love. The story shows that animals also feel love and express their feeling to them who love them. Baba showed so many qualities like that of humans, like love, affection, care, and loyalty. Understand? Even the wild animals, but it shows the affection also. Okay, and shared a bond of love with the narrator's wife. So very interesting story, very nice story, the bond of love, written by Kenneth Anderson. I hope you understood this summary. We'll see the detailed explanation in the next lecture. Thank you and have a nice day.